I'll look at Acts chapter 7 and verse 35. This Moses, whom they refused, saying, who made thee a ruler and a judge? The same did God send to be a ruler and a deliverer by the hand of the angel which appeared to him in the bush. That is, in the burning bush, if you know anything about the Bible, in the Old Testament. He brought them out after that. He had showed wonders and signs in the land of Egypt and in the Red Sea and in the wilderness 40 years. This is that Moses which said unto the children of Israel, a prophet shall the Lord your God raise up unto you of your brethren, like unto me, him shall ye hear. This is he that was in the church in the wilderness with the angel which spake to him in the Mount Sinai, and with our fathers who received the like lively oracles to give unto us, to whom our fathers would not obey, but thrust him from them, and in their hearts turned back again into Egypt. Now Egypt is a picture of the world, and the Christian has been taken out of the world. They've been translated into the wonderful kingdom of God through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. I wonder, is that your case? Have you believed on the Lord Jesus Christ? Have you put your faith in him for your eternal salvation? This is absolutely essential, my friend. If you want to be in heaven, you have to come God's way. And God's way is through the Lord Jesus Christ. You've got to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. Very simple. That's why most people are missing out on God's eternal salvation, because they think they've got to be good enough to impress God. It won't work. It's all bound up in the person of the Lord Jesus Christ and his finished work upon the cross of Calvary for you and for me. Yes, saying unto Aaron, make us gods to go before us. As for this Moses, for as for this Moses who brought us out of the land of Egypt, we wot not what is become of him. In other words, we don't know what is become of him. They were becoming impatient because Moses, I think from memory, was up in the Mount Sinai for about 40 days, I think it was. And they made a calf in those days and offered sacrifice unto the idol. You see, anything else apart from God is an idol. We need to understand, God wants us to worship him. God designed us to worship him and to glorify him and to live for him in an acceptable manner by the power of the Holy Spirit. We can't do that until we be born again into God's family through faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. As I said, and they made a calf in those days and offered sacrifice unto the idol and rejoiced in the works of their own hands. See, this is signifying man-made religion. It's useless. It's vain. It's empty. It's absolutely worth nothing in the sight of the Lord. All our righteousnesses are as filthy rags in the sight of the Lord. We need to understand that. The only sacrifice that the Lord God accepts is the sacrifice of his beloved Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who was crucified upon the cross of Calvary. Why? Because of your sins and mine. You and I have sinned in the sight of the Lord. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. For the wages of sin is death. That's the problem. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. So, if you want to be in heaven, as I've said, you'll have to come God's way. And God's way is through the Lord Jesus Christ. That's why the Bible says, he that hath the Son hath life. He that hath not the Son of God hath not life. Do you have the Son of God for your eternal salvation? Have you believed on him? Have you received him as your Savior? Then God turned and gave them up to worship the host of heaven, as it is written in the book of the prophets, O ye house of Israel, have ye offered to me slain beasts and sacrifices by the space of 40 years in the wilderness? Yea, ye took up the tabernacle of Molech, and the star of your god, Remphan, figures which ye made to worship them, and I will carry you away beyond Jordan. Our fathers had the tabernacle of witness in the wilderness, as he had appointed, speaking unto Moses that he should make it according to the fashion that he had seen, which also our fathers that came after brought in with Jesus into the possession of the Gentiles, whom God drave out before the face of our fathers unto the days of David. Unto the days of David, who found favor before God and desired to find a tabernacle for the God of Jacob. But Solomon built him an house. Howbeit the Most High dwelleth not in temples made with hands, as saith the prophet, Heaven is my throne, and earth is my footstool. What house will ye build me, saith the Lord? Or what is the place of my rest? Hath not my hand made all these things? Ye stiff-necked and uncircumcised in heart and ears, ye do always resist the Holy Spirit. As your fathers did, so do ye. I wonder this afternoon, this evening, are you resisting the Holy Spirit? The conviction of the Holy Spirit that will come upon you when we as gospel preachers preach the gospel of Jesus Christ unto you. You see, the Holy Spirit has been sent to bring conviction upon this world of sin, of righteousness, and of judgment. You see, we have sinned in the sight of the Lord. We need forgiveness for those sins. And the only way of forgiveness is through the death, burial, and resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ and his precious blood that was shed that day on that cross, in whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins. Have you received forgiveness for your sins? Are you still on the broad road that leads down to hell and destruction? God wants you to be saved, my friend. God wants you to come to his Son, Jesus Christ, and believe upon him to the salvation of your soul. Your soul that goes out into eternity when we die. Our soul will leave our body, my friend. And it's either going to be in heaven through the Lord Jesus Christ, or it's going to be down in hell because we've rejected or neglected the Lord Jesus Christ, who this evening desires to be your Savior. You see, Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. That means he came to save you, and he came to save me. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, being justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. If you ever want to be in heaven, you'll have to come God's way. And as I said, God's way is through the Lord Jesus Christ. You'll have to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. You'll have to come in repentance toward God. That is, a change of mind, simply agree with God that you are a sinner, and then place your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, and then your soul will be saved. This is what God wants for each and every one of us, that we would be in heaven at the end of the day of this little life on earth. It might be 60, 80, 100 years, whatever. We need to be in heaven. And the only way to be in heaven is through the Lord Jesus Christ and his once-for-all sacrifice upon the cross of Calvary. Which of the prophets have not your fathers persecuted, and they have slain them which showed before of the coming of the Just One, that is Jesus Christ, of whom ye have been now the betrayers and murderers, who have received the law by the disposition of angels, and have not kept it? When they heard these things, they were cut to the heart, and they gnashed on him with their teeth. But he, being full of the Holy Spirit, this is Stephen, looked up steadfastly into heaven, and saw the glory of God, and Jesus standing at the right hand of God, and said, Behold, I see the heavens opened, and the Son of Man standing on the right hand of God. And said, Behold, I see the heavens opened, as I said, and the Son of Man standing on the right hand of God. Then they cried out with a loud voice, and stopped their ears, and ran upon him with one accord, and cast him out of the city, and stoned him. and the witnesses laid down their clothes at a young man's feet whose name was Saul. This is Saul of Tarsus. And they stoned Stephen, calling upon God and saying, Lord Jesus, receive my spirit. And he kneeled down and cried with a loud voice, Lord, lay not this sin to their charge. And they that had said this, and when he had said this, he fell asleep. In other words, he died. It's a lovely terminology that the Lord uses for all of his dear people, his children, that they fall asleep in Jesus. In other words, they die. Their spirit and soul leave their body and they go to heaven. Praise the Lord for every true child of God. Are you a child of God? Have you put your faith in Christ? Are you ready for heaven? Are you on your way to heaven? Or are you still on the broad road that leads down to hell and destruction? No need to go down to hell. God wants you to be in heaven. But the only way you can be there is through the once-for-all sacrifice of Jesus Christ upon the cross and your right response to that. You see, you can walk past and as I often say, she'll be right, mate. I don't care. Doesn't bother me. It's all good. It won't be good. It's not good because you're heading down to hell. And God does not want you to be in hell, my friend. He wants you to be in heaven. That's why the Lord Jesus Christ came and left heaven's glory. Come down to this sin-cursed earth to die upon the cross for sinners such as you and I. When we're born in this world, we are born as sinners. God wants to make you a saint this evening, my friend. He wants to give you his righteousness so that you can enter into heaven. Won't be able to enter into heaven unless we have the righteousness of God through faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. What will you do then with Jesus, which is called the Christ? Will he be your Savior? Or will he have to be your judge? You know, we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins. If you're interested in this, look me up, youtube.com/peace by Jesus Christ. God bless you, and thanks for listening. Acts chapter 8, and Saul was consenting unto his death. This is the first Christian martyr who just read concerning Stephen, who was the first Christian martyr who was stoned to death because of his faith in Christ. And that was Acts chapter 7, the end of Acts chapter 7. Now we come to Acts chapter 8, and Saul was consenting unto his death. And at that time, this is Saul of Tarsus, and at that time there was a great persecution against the church, which was at Jerusalem, and they were all scattered abroad throughout the regions of Judea and Samaria, except the apostles. And devout men carried Stephen to his burial, and made great lamentation over him. As for Saul, he made havoc of the church, entering into every house and hailing men and women, committed them to prison. Therefore they that were scattered abroad went everywhere preaching the word. That's what I like to hear. They went everywhere preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ unto the people. Then Philip went down to the city of Samaria and preached Christ unto them. And the people with one accord gave heed unto those things which Philip spake, hearing and seeing the miracles which he did. For unclean spirits, in other words demons, crying with loud voice, came out of many that were possessed with them, and many taken with palsies, and that were lame were healed. And there was great joy in that city, but there was a certain man called Simon, which before time in the same city used sorcery, and bewitched the people of Samaria, giving out that himself was some great one. Well, this person was whiz to witchcraft or Satanism, to whom they all gave heed from the least to the greatest, saying, this man is the great power of God. And to him they had regard because that of a long time, he had bewitched them with sorceries. But when they believed Philip preaching the things concerning the kingdom of God and the name of Jesus Christ, they were baptized, both men and women. You see, these people, this is called believer's baptism. These are the people who should be baptized, those who are saved, those who have come to faith in Christ. If you're a Christian and you haven't been baptized, you need to get baptized. It's the wish of the Lord. It's the command of the Lord, actually. He actually commanded baptism for the children of God, that they might take the next step of faith, and that is water baptism, full immersion. That's believer's baptism. It's got nothing to do with getting to heaven whatsoever. It's just an obedience, it's a step of obedience for the child of God. But if you're not saved, you need to be saved. You need to come to know the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior. Then Simon himself believed also, and when he was baptized, he continued with Philip and wondered, beholding the miracles and signs which were done. Now when the apostles which were at Jerusalem heard that Samaria had received the word of God, they sent unto them Peter and John, who, when they were come down, prayed for them that they might receive the Holy Spirit. Now this was what we call a transitionary sort of a period. Now when a believer, at this point of time, now when someone believes on the Lord Jesus Christ, they receive the Holy Spirit upon conversion, upon the time that they're saved. When they put their faith in Jesus Christ as their Savior, the Holy Spirit comes to dwell within their body. For as yet, he was fallen on none of them, only they were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus. Then laid they their hands on them, and they received the Holy Spirit. And when Simon saw that through laying on of the apostles' hands, the Holy Spirit was given, he offered them money, saying, "Give me also this power, that on whomsoever I lay hands, he may receive the Holy Spirit." But Peter said unto him, "Thy money perish with thee, because thou hast thought that the gift of God may be purchased with money. Thou hast neither part nor lot in this matter, for thy heart is not right in the sight of God. Repent therefore of this thy wickedness, and pray God if perhaps in the thought of thine heart may be forgiven thee. For I perceive that thou art in the gall of bitterness, and in the bond of iniquity." Then answered Simon and said, "Pray ye to the Lord for me, that none of these things which ye have spoken come upon me." And they, when they had testified and preached the word of the Lord, returned to Jerusalem and preached the gospel in many villages of the Samaritans. And the angel of the Lord spake unto Philip, saying, "Arise, and go toward the south unto the way that goeth down from Jerusalem unto Gaza, which is desert." And he arose and went, and behold, a man of Ethiopia, an eunuch of great authority under Candace, queen of the Ethiopians. In other words, he was an African man, a dark man, who had the charge of all her treasure, and had come to Jerusalem for to worship, was returning and sitting in his chariot, read Isaiah the prophet. Then the Spirit, that is the Holy Spirit, said unto Philip, "Go near and join thyself to this chariot." And Philip ran there to him, and heard him read the prophet Isaiah, and said, "Understandest thou what thou readest?" In other words, do you understand what you're reading? And he said, "How can I, except some man should guide me?" And he desired Philip that he would come up and sit with him, that is, sit with him in the chariot. This is the Ethiopian eunuch. And the place of the scripture which he read was this: "He was led as a sheep to the slaughter." This is speaking of Jesus Christ. "And like a lamb dumb before his shearer, so opened he not his mouth. In his humiliation his judgment was taken away, and who shall declare his generation? For his life is taken from the earth." And the eunuch answered Philip and said, "I pray thee, of whom speaketh the prophet this? the prophetess of himself or of some other man. Then Philip opened his mouth and began at the same scripture, and preached unto him Jesus. And as they went on their way, they came unto a certain water, and the eunuch said, See, here is water. What doth hinder me to be baptized? In other words, what's holding me up to be baptized? And Philip said, If thou believest with all thy heart, thou mayest. In other words, if you're really a believer, if you're really a Christian, if you have really trusted Christ, received Christ as your Savior, you can be baptized. And as I said earlier in this message, this is the desire of the Lord for each and every one of us. If we're saved, if we're Christian, you need to get baptized. This is the command of the Lord. It's the next step in obedience. As I said, it's got nothing to do with salvation. It won't get us to heaven, but it's called what we call believer's baptism. Full immersion in water, it signifies the death, burial, and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, and our burial and death, burial, and resurrection with him that has already taken place when we believe on Christ. When we trust Christ as our Savior, our soul is saved. This is what God wants for each and every one of us this evening, my friend, that your soul be saved, that you would have forgiveness for your sins. And that forgiveness is only possible through the precious shed blood of the Lord Jesus Christ, which he shed for us freely and abundantly upon the cross of Calvary. You see, when one of the soldiers came, they saw that he was dead already, and came and thrust a spear into his side. And forthwith there came out blood and water. That blood still has the power to wash your sins away, my friend. And I hope that's the case for you this evening. That you come to faith in Christ. That you put your faith in him. That you come in repentance toward God, as I've said. That is a change of mind. Simply agree with God that you are a sinner. And then place your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ and your soul will be saved. The question was asked a long time ago, what must I do to be saved? The simple answer was, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. That can be yours this evening. You can be saved by the grace of God through faith in the person and the work of the Lord Jesus Christ. He that hath the Son hath life. He that hath not the Son of God hath not life. Do you have the Son of God? Have you believed on him for your eternal salvation? Salvation is of the Lord, and if you're ever going to be saved, left to be God's word. And God has come down in the person of Jesus Christ. He left heaven's glory and took upon himself a body, that he, by the grace of God, should taste death for every man upon the cross of Calvary. And so this man, this Ethiopian eunuch, this African man, he was saved by the grace of God. He put his faith in Jesus Christ as his personal Savior. That which you must do if you want to be in heaven. You won't be in heaven apart from Jesus Christ. He said, Come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me. For I am meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest unto your souls. My yoke is easy, and my burden is light. Have you come to Christ? Are you a child of God? Have you been born again into God's family through faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ? And so he said here, Philip said up and said to the Ethiopian eunuch, If thou believest with all thine heart, thou mayest, in other words, mayest be baptized. And he answered and said, I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. In other words, he was saved. He was a believer through faith in Jesus Christ. And he commanded the chariot to stand still, and they went down both into the water, both Philip and the eunuch, and he baptized him. And when they were come up out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord caught away Philip, that the eunuch saw him no more. And he went on his way rejoicing. Praise the Lord for every true child of God. They'll be rejoicing. The day that they get saved, they'll be rejoicing to know him through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, knowing that they have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, be justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. It's good that as I see a few Christians around the place, it's good. Nice to have a bit of encouragement. But Philip was found at Azotus and passed through and passing through he preached in all the cities till he came to Caesarea. What a wonderful thing that was. He was preaching the gospel wherever he went. That's what I try to do myself personally. Preach the gospel wherever I can so that people will come to faith in Christ. This is an urgent message, my friend. We are perishing without Christ. We're heading down to hell without Christ. We must believe on Christ to be saved. You must trust Christ as your Savior. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Do it now before it's forever and eternally too late. For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Come in repentance toward God, as I've said. Change your mind. Agree with God that you are a sinner, and then put your faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and your soul will be saved, and you will become a child of God through faith alone in the person of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. If you're interested in this, look me up at youtube.com/peace by Jesus Christ. God bless you, and thanks for listening.
Dave here again. Look, I want to look at Acts chapter 9 now. Acts chapter 9. And Saul, yet breathing out threatenings and slaughter against the disciples of the Lord, went unto the high priest and desired of him letters to Damascus, to the synagogues, that if he found any of this way, that is, any believers, any Christians, whether they were men or women, he might bring them bound unto Jerusalem. And as he journeyed, he came near Damascus, and suddenly there shined round about him a light from heaven. And he fell to the earth, and heard a voice saying unto him, Saul, Saul, why persecutest thou me? And he said, Who art thou, Lord? And the Lord said, I am Jesus, whom thou persecutest. It is hard for thee to kick against the pricks. And he, trembling and astonished, said, Lord, what wilt thou have me to do? He is a willing believer who wants to know what the Lord has for him, what the Lord would have him to do. And that's a great thing, if you're a believer, to want to do the will of the Lord. You want to do that which is right in the sight of the Lord. Do that which is commissioned unto you, and whatever your gift is, that you can fulfill that gift, whether it's preaching the gospel or whatever it is, that you might get that job done. While we're here on earth, time is running out. And we as believers, we as Christians, must understand that we will all stand before the judgment seat of Christ to give an account what we've done. And, you know, if we've been given a gift in a certain area and we haven't used that, well, then we will lose reward. And it won't be nice when the time of our evaluation for our works comes. But we know that this is really, I'm really preaching to those who are not saved now, obviously. So if you're not saved, you need to get right with God. You need to believe on the Lord Jesus Christ to become a child of God and have a forgiveness for your sins through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. And like I said, this man said, Lord, what wilt thou have me to do? Good attitude for a believer, for a Christian. And the Lord said unto him, Arise and go into the city, and it shall be told thee what thou must do. And the men which journeyed with him stood speechless, hearing a voice, but seeing no man. And Saul arose from the earth, and when his eyes were opened, he saw no man. But they led him by the hand and brought him into Damascus. And he was 3 days without sight, and neither did eat nor drink. And there was a certain disciple at Damascus named Ananias. And to him said the Lord in a vision, Ananias, and he said, Behold, I am here, Lord, a willing servant of the Lord. And the Lord said unto him, Arise and go into the street which is called Straight, and inquire in the house of Judas for one called Saul of Tarsus, for behold, he prayeth, and hath seen in a vision a man named Ananias coming in and putting his hand on him, that he might receive his sight. Then Ananias said, Lord, I have heard by many of this man how much evil he hath done to thy saints at Jerusalem. And here he hath authority from the chief priests to bind all that call on thy name. But the Lord said unto him, Go thy way, for he is a chosen vessel unto me, to bear my name before the Gentiles, and kings, and the children of Israel. For I will show him how great things he must suffer for my name's sake. And Ananias went his way, and entered into the house, and putting his hands on him, said, Brother Saul, the Lord, even Jesus, that appeared unto thee in the way as thou camest, hath sent me, that thou mightest receive thy sight, and be filled with the Holy Spirit. And immediately there fell from his eyes as it had been scales, and he received sight forthwith, and arose and was baptized. And when he had received meat, he was strengthened. Then was Saul certain days with the disciples which were at Damascus. And straightway he preached Christ in the synagogues, that he is the Son of God. Straight away he was into service for the Lord. That's good, isn't it? When we think of someone getting saved and then getting baptized, it's the first step of obedience in following the Lord in that way, to be baptized. That's full immersion. That is believer's baptism. It doesn't save us, but it's for believers, those who have been saved, that they would take that next step of obedience and be baptized, full immersion in water. So that is the first step of obedience for a child of God. And straightway he preached Christ in the synagogues, that he is the Son of God. He didn't wait around. He got straight into what God had for him. God had ordained that he should be a preacher of the gospel. And so he went straight into it and got stuck into it. And this is what we should do as the people of God. If you're a believer and you're watching this video right now, find out what your gift is and go in for it, my friend. Go in for it, my brother or sister. Get the job done that the Lord has allotted for you to do on our way to heaven, while we wait for the coming of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And all that heard him were amazed and said, Is not this he that destroyed them which called on this name in Jerusalem? And came here for that intent, that he might bring them bound unto the chief priests. But Saul increased the more in strength, and confounded the Jews which dwelt at Damascus, proving that this is very Christ. In other words, he's God's anointed, the chosen one of God, that would be the Savior, to take our sins away, to wash our sins away in the precious blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. And this could be yours if you come in repentance toward God, which is a change of mind. Simply agree with God that you're a sinner, and then put your faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And after that many days were fulfilled, the Jews took counsel to kill him. But their laying await was known of Saul, and they watched the gates day and night to kill him. Then the disciples took him by night and led him down by the wall in a basket. And when Saul was come to Jerusalem, he essayed or attempted to join himself to the disciples, but they were all afraid of him and believed not that he was a disciple. They thought, oh, blow this. This man is going to persecute us. This man is an imposter. He's just coming to spy out the situation that we're in here. He's only come here to harvest. But Barnabas took him and brought him to the apostles and declared unto them how he had seen the Lord in the way, and that he had spoken to him, and how he had preached boldly at Damascus in the name of Jesus. And he was with them coming in and going out at Jerusalem. And he spake boldly in the name of the Lord Jesus, and disputed against the Grecians, but they went about to slay him. They wanted to kill him. Which, when the brethren knew, they brought him down to Caesarea and sent him forth to Tarsus. Then had the churches rest throughout all Judea and Galilee and Samaria, and were edified, and walking in the fear of the Lord and in the comfort of the Holy Spirit were multiplied. And it came to pass, as Peter passed throughout all quarters, he came down also to the saints which dwelt at Lydda. And there he found a certain man named Aeneas, which had kept his bed 8 years and was sick of the palsy. And Peter said unto him, Aeneas, Jesus Christ maketh thee whole. Arise and make thy bed. And he arose immediately. And all that dwelt at Lydda and Saron saw him and turned to the Lord. This is my prayer unto the Lord for you right now, that you would turn unto the Lord, that you would come to the Lord for your eternal salvation. Now there was at Joppa a certain disciple named Tabitha, which by interpretation is called Dorcas. This woman was full of good works and alms deeds which she did. And it came to pass in those days that she was sick and died, whom, when they had washed, they laid her in an upper chamber. And forasmuch as Lydda was nigh to Joppa, or near to Joppa, and the disciples had heard that John was there, they went unto him, they sent unto him two men, desiring him that he would not delay to come to them. Then Peter arose and went with them. When he was come, they brought him into the upper chamber, and all the windows stood by him, and all the widows stood by him weeping, and showing the coats and garments which Dorcas made while she was with them. But Peter put them all forth, and kneeled down and prayed, and turning him to the body, said, Tabitha, arise. And she opened her eyes, and when she saw Peter, she sat up. And he gave her his hand and lifted her up. And when he had called the saints and widows, presented her alive. And it was known throughout all Joppa, and many believed in the Lord. And it came to pass that he tarried many days in Joppa with one Simon, a tanner. So, what if that will be you? And it was known throughout all Joppa, and many believed in the Lord. Are you prepared to believe in the Lord? and become one of God's children through faith alone in the Lord Jesus Christ. You need to do that, you know, to be in heaven. Well, you won't be in heaven apart from the Lord Jesus Christ. We've got to come to Christ for salvation. He's the only way of salvation, in whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins. What are your sins forgiven? If you're interested in this, look me up, youtube.com/peacebyjesuschrist. God bless you, and thanks for listening. Remember, it's either heaven or hell. What will it be for you? It all depends what you do with the Son of God, the Lord Jesus Christ. Will he be your Savior, or will he have to be your judge? Well, have a great day. I hope you've understood the message.